Because there were only a limited amount of clones being produced on Kamino, and an even smaller amount trained and ready to serve, the Republic relied on many local planetary defense forces to keep the Republic world safe from the Separatist droid army. One of these defense forces fought so valiantly to defend a vital Republic communication center, but when they called for backup, nobody came. Because the Republic was so unwilling to send help to their world, the general in charge of the force became convinced that someone inside the Republic government wanted the Separatists to take control of the planet and wanted the Republic to fall. So, let's find out what went down. Before we get into it, make sure you're subscribed for more awesome Star Wars lore content. The Praesitlan Defense Force was a Republic military force stationed on the planet Praesitlan and was made up of very valiant fighters. This force was officially considered part of the Grand Army of the Republic, but was not led by a Jedi general and was not made up of clone troopers born on Kamino. Instead, it was led by the human General Kamar, and the troopers were led by Commander Lanmor, another human-born soldier. The force also consisted of a few officers from the reptilian Sluissi species, who were known for their unbreakable patience and willingness to follow protocol, no matter how stupid or pointless it seemed. The members of this defense force included Lieutenant Irk Harmon, a T-19 pilot, General Kamar himself, Lieutenant Colonel Crean, who was an engineer, Commander Lanmor, of course commanding the ground troopers, Sergeant Max Maganini, the scout team leader, Pleth Strom, another T-19 pilot, Odie Subu and Tami, also scouts, and finally, Waterboy, who was an air traffic controller. The force was also outfitted with at least two battalions of ground troopers, several wings of T-19 starfighters, and several recon platoons, which were each given civilian land speeders, which were refurbished into military-grade vehicles. Each platoon was only given one set of TT-4 macro binoculars also, making their recon missions not the easiest. This defense force was in charge of defending the crucial intergalactic communication system on their home planet, which was the backbone of all Republic communications in the core of the galaxy. If this planet were to fall to the Separatists, the Republic's communication times would take far longer and of course be far less secure. After months of waiting, General Kamar's forces began to wear tired, and he felt that his force was far too small to defend the planet and the communication station, wondering what he could possibly do. Because of this, he contacted Coruscant, but on multiple occasions they refused to send him aid, leading him to become furious with the Republic government. This situation brewed a massive feeling within him that the Republic wanted the Separatists to attack this crucial world, and that someone near the top of the Republic Senate was actually working with the Separatists. Unfortunately, he didn't know just how grave the situation truly was, with Palpatine pulling the strings on both sides of the war. The general and his men intended to bring these concerns to the Jedi Council, or someone else in the Republic government, but unfortunately, their entire squad was wiped out during the Battle of Praesitlan. The man who could have helped alert the Jedi Order to their impending doom would never get the chance to voice his concern. Thanks so much for watching, really hope you enjoyed the video. Cheers guys, hope to see you in the next one.